Hi Brent, how you doing?
Not too bad, how about yourself?
Pretty good. I like your office.
Thank you, it's a good one.
Air conditioning is good.
Yeah, very, very cool most of the year.
I think people who come out from the UK here want to make sure that they know who they're coming out to.
They're going to survive their trip.
So, just tell us a little bit about who you are.
Well, my name is Brent Sass. I'm originally from Minnesota, and I moved to Alaska 10 years ago to fulfill a dream, and have been living it ever since. I've been dog mushing for 5 years. I have a kennel of 45 dogs right now, and I raise and train Alaskan Huskies. Yeah, I've got I have 5 acres of property here, and 6 major structures where I can house a number of people in an authentic Alaskan log cabin that I've built. I built all 6 of the places here. And it's right next to the dogs. There's one of the cabins is right over there. It's a great place to get to know dogs. And like I said, I have 45 here, ranging from just puppies all the way to 11-year-old dog. So I've got a real variety of dogs and a great experience to be had as well.
I mean, this is the playground right next to us as well, so you don't have to go far.
It is. We go right out of here, and we're at sort of on the outskirts of the town, of the city here, and we head off into the wilderness right from this place. It's a great spot. We can go hundreds of miles on trips right out of my place here. Moose, there's lots of moose. We saw 2 moose. We saw tons of tracks crossing the trail. Actually, we usually have moose that hang out right in this area here. A lot of times the dogs will be barking for hours straight, and you walk out here and there's just moose kind of wandering around in the woods right out here.
Sun goes out, you'll be standing by yourself. Sun goes out, you'll be standing by yourself. 10 men slave across the ocean, they had shackles on their leg. 10 men slave across the ocean, they had shackles.
All right, we're just going to see him here. This guy here is the dude. He's 4-year-old. He was in my 1,000-mile Yukon Quest race this year. This is Ling Ling. Same way, he was in my 1,000-mile quest this year. This girl here is Jerry. She was in another team, a different team in the race this year. This is Molly. She's a little bit of a shy dog. And we have Eagle with the white eyes here. Eagle was in my race this year. This dog here is Muskrat. She only weighs 30 pounds, but she's all of that 30 pounds is put to work, no doubt. She loves to run. Bust is a great dog. He's one of my main leaders as well. And we have Budget. Budget finished the 1,000-mile race as well. A great dog, lots of spirit. Thunder. Thunder was in my team this year as well. Great dog, lots of love. And we have Taco. Taco is a dog I've had for a long time. He's 6 years old and was in my race team. Real powerful team today.
My goal in bringing these trips and bringing people to Wild and Free Kennel, that's the name of my kennel here in Fairbanks, is to sort of engulf you in the lifestyle, let you know exactly what it's like to be a dog musher, to have the relationship with the dogs. And it means, you know, getting up and watering the dogs and spending the time that I do, going through the routine that I do every single day of my life, and really bonding with the dog so that when you get out on the trail and start mushing, you're able to actually get the feeling of what it's like to be a dog musher and what it's like to be out there on the trail. We're gonna go out of town. About an hour and a half is a remote hot springs, and it's a resort. On the way out, we'll probably do a hike, see some new area and snowshoeing, and then when we get to the hot springs, there's a wonderful huge pool of hot water that's boiling out of the ground. And then at night, we'll take a trek with some Susvies and go to the top of a mountain and hopefully be able to view some aurora, some northern lights from the top of a mountain. Yeah, we'll hook a team up. You'll have 6 or 8 dogs, and we'll hook a team up with the sled, and you'll get to follow me and have just the exact same experience that I have out there on the trail, and feel the power that these dogs create and the excitement. They really love what they do, and you'll be able to see their enjoyment while you're out there on the trail.